said she didn't know her husband could access the appointment system early. Tonight, NBC2's Megan Myers gets us answers after talking with the city manager.
Tonight, we're finally seeing text messages Chief Frizzano sent that put her husband first in line. We know exactly what the chief told him to do and when to do it, securing himself a shot before hundreds of others desperate to do the same.
I had a concern on the surface whether what I found in that text message was consistent with what I'd gotten from the interview with the police chief.
In this message, you can see 15 minutes before the city's link went live, Chief Frizzano texted her husband, letting him know he was good to go.
When she says in that message, you know, I spoke to them, you're good, was she talking about the fire chief?
Yes.
City Manager McNeese announced on February 3rd, both the police chief and the fire chief would be suspended for 30 days. Then McNeese reopened the investigation on February 8th after these texts surfaced. He looked back on his interview with Frizzano and compared it to these texts.
It turned out there really were no inconsistencies. There wasn't any problem. There was nothing that didn't line up the way I thought it had.
So again, he closed the case. I asked why Frizzano told her husband in this text message to try going in before 2 o'clock.
I think the way the other systems were working, you logged in and then when it went live, you could get a reservation.
McNeese says Frizzano stands by not thinking a reservation could be made before 2, saying she spoke to the fire chief.
She, in her own statement, said, I thought he was in charge of it, and when he said it was good, it was good.
But that answer isn't good enough for some people who waited for what felt like an eternity to get their shot.
Getting up every day, 3 times a week at 5 o'clock, and then just seeing all the appointments go away, it was very, very frustrating.
And knowing some people in a position of power skip the line.
Someone like that, who takes advantage of access that they have by virtue of being in the police department or the fire department, I just find them not to be honorable.
On Marco Island, Megan Myers, NBC2.
As for the fire.